All right, guys, how you doing? We're going to do another Bible study. Let's get right into it. This is going to be a Bible study on Jude. J-U-D-E. You're going to find this very interesting. Guess who Jude is? Jude is the brother of Jesus Christ. So you're going to really enjoy this. So before we get started with the Bible study, look at the top of the page here. See where it says shotgunnow.net. Want to give you guys some free gifts. Go here and click Music and Podcast. You're going to love that. And then also click, where is it? I'm going to show you how you can get some free audiobooks right here on the bottom right. And then let's look for the free audio Bible right here. You can get the entire Bible, Old and New Testament, for free. So let's get started. We're going to talk to you about Jude. Now, before we get into the Bible study, let's talk a little bit about Jude. The book of Jude is known as one of the shortest books in the New Testament. And what you're going to find, you guys, is that it focuses on the proliferation of false teachers in Jude's time, as well as on the great apostasy that is to come in the last days. That will occur before the return of Jesus Christ. So as people start falling away from the faith in Jesus Christ, that will happen before the return of Jesus Christ. And biblical scholars say that Jude was written around A.D. 65 by Jude, one of Jesus' half-brothers. It warns against specific heresies that were starting to develop at that time. Eventually known as the Gnostics, these teachers ignored the biblical call to morality and denied that Jesus is God. In essence, what you're going to see here as I go through Jude with you guys is they turned grace into a justification for sin. They claimed that because of God's love, they could commit any sins they wanted to and still be forgiven, a recurring problem that has plagued the church throughout its long history. These people committed some of the worst sins imaginable, denying what Christ did for us, turning from the right, and instead willfully choosing the wrong. Jude will warn of their impending doom as I go through this. You'll hear him doing that. And he'll warn us, you and I, not to follow their ways. He cites the historical examples of the Exodus and Sodom and Gomorrah in order to remind us that God never treats sin lightly. Long ago, the conviction and judgment of such people was prophesied, and they will get the full measure of punishment they deserve. That's right from Jude, which I'm going to read to you. In order to avoid their fate, Jude says, we are to build up ourselves in our most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit. We are to keep ourselves in the love of God, which means we are to remain close to Him, following Him wholeheartedly, careful to eagerly obey His commandments. Those who struggle, we are to help, and God Himself is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you faultless before the presence of His glory with exceeding joy. So you're going to enjoy this. Let's get into Jude. It starts off, Jude, the servant of Jesus Christ and brother of James, to them that are sanctified by God the Father and preserved in Jesus Christ and called, mercy unto you and peace and love be multiplied. Beloved, when I gave all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation, it was needful for me, watch this, what he starts off with, to write unto you and exhort that you should earnestly contend for the faith which was once delivered unto the saints. Why is he saying this? To stay, you know, strong in the faith and earnestly contend for it. He says, here's why, there's a problem. Already it's happening. He says, for there are certain men crept in unawares, they snuck in, who were before of old ordained to this condemnation, ungodly men, turning the grace of our God into lasciviousness and denying the only Lord God and our Lord Jesus Christ. I will therefore put you in remembrance, though you once knew this, how the Lord how that the Lord, having saved the people out of the land of Egypt, afterward destroyed them that believed not. And the angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation, these are the demons that he's talking about, he hath reserved in everlasting chains under darkness, under the judgment of the great day. And then he talks about, remember Sodom and Gomorrah, where the wicked homosexuals were at. He says, even as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them in like manner, giving themselves over to fornication. And Jude's not politically correct, which is why I love him. So look what he says about the homosexuals. And going after strange flesh are set forth for an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire. Likewise, also these filthy dreamers defile the flesh, despise dominion, and speak evil of dignities. Yet Michael the archangel, when contending with the devil, he disputed about the body of Moses. What happens when you read scripture, Moses dies and Satan is trying to seize the body of Moses. And Michael the archangel fights Satan, but Satan's so powerful that Michael, notice it says, does not bring against him a railing accusation, but says rather, quote, the Lord rebuke thee, because that's where the power is at. But these speak evil of those things which they know not, but in what they know naturally as brute beast, in those things they corrupt themselves. And I'm going to read something to you guys. It's just a beautiful poetic way that Jude writes this. Watch this. It's just very well done. He says, woe unto them, for they have gone in the way of Cain. Remember Cain when he displeased God and he killed his own brother, and ran greedily after the heir of Balaam for reward, and perished in the gainsaying of Kor. Now this is where it gets very poetic. Watch this. It's pretty good the way he writes this. Watch this. These are spots in your feast of charity, when they feast with you, feeding themselves without fear. Clouds they are without water, carried about of winds, trees whose fruit wherewith without fruit, twice dead, plucked up by the roots. Raging waves of the sea, foaming out their own shame, wandering stars to whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. Very poetic. He gets very poetic here. And Enoch, also the seventh from Adam, prophesied of these, saying, behold, the Lord cometh with 10,000s of his saints to execute judgment upon all, and to convince all that are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have ungodly committed, and of all their hard speeches which ungodly sinners have spoken against them. So notice, a lot of times with our modern society, people don't want to talk about judgment. Well, that's what Christ is returning for, is judgment. Notice he's saying it to execute judgment upon all, and to convince all that are ungodly. He says ungodly once there, ungodly there a second time, ungodly a third time, and then again ungodly a fourth time. He says, these are murmurers, complainers, walking after their own lust, and their mouth speaketh great swelling words, having men's persons in admiration because of advantage. But beloved, remember you the words which were spoken before of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time, who should walk after their own, look at a fifth time he says it, ungodly lust. These be they who separate themselves, sensual, having not the Spirit. But ye, beloved, building up yourselves on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost, keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life, and of some have compassion, making a difference, and others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire. And this is a phrase that is very famous. A lot of preachers will talk about this, hating even the garment spotted by the flesh. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. Amen. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Don't forget to go to shotgunal.net right here and click music and podcast. You're going to like this. Let me just click this for you real quick. I want to show you something. Why I want you to go here. This part's real interesting. When music and podcast page pulls up, you can listen to this interesting thing here about Obama. You could listen to Bart Ehrman, who is destroyed in debate. He's agnostic. He got destroyed in debate. You could, if you're into science and how science proves God's existence, it is evidence of it, proof and evidence. Listen to this one, God in Fine Tuning. If you've heard that the Bible has contradictions and all this stuff, it's not true. Go here and click Alleged Bible Contradictions Debunked. This was really good. There was an amazing article on atheism. You want to listen to this one. You just click play here, or you could download it for your MP3 player. I really like this. This was a debate on how DNA is proof and evidence of intelligent design. And then here's a gangster that becomes a Christian, and he preaches just some radical preaching. And we got like 8 pages of these MP3s that you can listen to. You listen to one, you'll be hooked. I say you go here and listen to this one right here, The Shocking Evils of Obama. And I think you'll be hooked. So God bless you guys. Thanks for listening to the Bible study, and have a great week.